Welcome to the behind the score of the Koryo Hall of Adventures. A friend of mine living in Korea is working on a Kickstarter, and he asked me if I wanted to score his campaign video. And yeah, it's a Korean-themed Dungeons & Dragons adventure, and yeah, let's take a look at the score. Let's go! Okay, so here we have the Logic project. I'm working on the Logic Pro X for this film scoring session, because obviously you have video support in Logic, and you can also export directly to the movie, so you get audio applied to the film directly, and that's very good because you don't have to use a second app just to include the music with the film. Okay, so let's play through this track, and then we will break it down. Let's go.
You're a newbie, aren't you? All right, here we go. This is the Koryo Hall of Adventures. You come in, you pick a job, and then you bring it to me. I assign it to you and your team, and then you go on your merry way. You know where you are, right? The hall's location. The hall is in Hagiriesta, one of the four realms of Chorsong. The other ones are Nunara in the north, Daewanguk in the east, and Haenamguk in the south. Oh, so you did pick a job. Let's see. You might want to take a shaman with you on this one. One that understands the Obangsek concept to the full. You know, Obangsek, the five pillars of our world. Earth, fire, water, air, and mind. This is not an easy mission for a newbie. I admire your courage. Make sure to take the northern path. It'll be safer, maybe. You're all set. Good luck, adventurer, and welcome as an official member of the Koryo Hall of Adventures.
Yeah, so that's the score for this Kickstarter trailer. Okay, so the first thing I do when I get a video to score is I do a playthrough, of course, and I listen for the pace and the tempo of the film. So you can look at my tempo map here. The director wanted the score to begin at about 24 seconds into the clip. So what I did is I added this marker, beginning, and yeah, let's just mute voiceover. And you can see my adjustments to the tempo here, so that the pacing would fit, so I can work with the metronome. Sometimes I score without the metronome, but in this case I was going with the metronome. Yeah, so this is a Korean-flavored Dungeons & Dragons campaign, and so we will use Korean-flavored instruments. And what I did first, after making a tempo map for this score, I did a playthrough and tried some melodic content, and I came up with this melody. Yeah, so that's a super simple melody, but you don't have to have complicated melodies, because what you will do is make the arrangement a little bit more complicated, but keep your melodies quite simple. As we can see here in the film, there's an important moment here where we have this a little bit of brooding, sinister creature appearing in the forest in the background here. You can see the demon in the background here. So I knew I wanted to include some kind of sinister or yeah, or more evil sound in the background for just that specific cue point in the score. And then, of course, we have this ending where you probably want to go a little bit more bombastic since this is a trailer. So I knew I was going to ramp up the dynamics and do a kind of finishing off this this track. Okay, so we talked about the melody and we talked about the tempo and we talked about a little bit about the instrumentation, which was going to be Korean flavored. Let's go back and for the intro here, I was going to keep it quite minimal. I wanted to have these concertino strings, soaring strings in the background, and then build with instrumentation, more and more Korean flavored instruments until this final cue in the end of the song. So I went and looked in the Tundra library. This is from Albion. It's some woodwinds with a long vibrato, and they are played very soft, and as you can see, we have them far in the background. Then I layered this. Yeah. There are some suspense notes, since you have the seconds going to the third and back to the second again. Then I also layered this with a super sultasto. It's a string also from Albion Tundra, which will give this more crispness and more air. And I layered this with a pad from Omnisphere. I recently did an Omnisphere video, Omnisphere 2.6 update video, which you can see, click on above here somewhere, if you want to watch that one. Okay, so we have this Omnisphere pad and it sounds like this. It's a toothbrush played on a hang drum and it's layered with a string patch. So there's a lot of interesting higher harmonics. And I also made a little EQ curve here. And that means that we will get more of the high end, more of the scraping, the toothbrush scraping. So that gives us more airy things happening in the upper range of the frequency spectrum. And aside from that, we go to the gusheng and we have the motif being played, the smallest part of the motif. So we will begin by playing a small part of the motif and then we will play more and more and yeah, the usual. And it sounds like this. And then we have the gusheng also, but with another preset, Ebow, which is sounds like a drone. And that's very good to have these drones in the background of your tracks. To fill up the space a little bit. Then we have this gaegeum, and it's a Korean instrument. Sounds like this. And it's layered with Geomungu, which is also Korean. And it's very good to layer your instruments because they fill different areas of the frequency spectrum, so you get a more full sound. And for this I introduced a lot of high-end because I want to bring out the crispness from that instrument. You can hear if I remove one of these, it will only sound like this. Very thin sounding. And then we add the second and we have a little bit more low end. So that's a quite nice full sound. Then in the background for the intro we have some piano delays, and that's just a regular piano that I ran through an delay effect, a reverse delay. And I used this custom sample, if you will, in a few places during this track. And you can also hear that the pitch is drifting on the delays. And that's because I'm using color copy from Yuhi. And it has a really nice pitch drifting function. Yeah, and then we go to the second part of the track where the instrumentation gets a little bit more wide and heavy. And we get to hear more of the main theme. We have this section of the Korean instruments. And here you can see, during this part, I left out the melody and replaced it with this sinister or more evil sounding bell part, which sounds like this. And that's a good, it's a good thing if you leave out some instruments, if you have sound effect heavy parts. And during this part we have this flame coming in. So I got rid of a lot of the bass heavy instruments and have had this bell going down instead.
Maybe. You're all set. Good luck, adventurer, and welcome as an...
And that's to make room for that sound effect. Okay, so you can see I have a lot of variations of the gusheng, and that's because during this first part we have the regular gusheng with a little bit of a room reverb. Yeah, so, and then we have this gusheng minus 12, which is the same instrument, but pitched 12 semitones below. It's an octave below. And I do that by this AU pitch, which is a very good hidden, if you will, pitch plugin of Logic. And it sounds like this. So that's the same instrument but pitched 12 semitones below. And it makes the sound more full because you have this upper register and then the lower register. So for the first part of the theme we have the upper register only, then we fill it in with a little bit more low end. I can play this part. So that's a quite thin sound, but we have it layered with this. And then we fill it in with the low end. So that's a little trick to make the melody a little bit more full. And then I also added this melody box, which is, it's not the typical Korean, but it gives a little bit more top end to the melody. Then we have this Dangpiri Duduk. I call it Duduk, but that's not really... I think it's called Dangpiri. Yeah, some kind of wind instrument from Korea, but... I added this Duduk naming because I think it sounded a little bit like a Duduk. Not fully, but a little bit. And it's in the background to fill out a little bit and make it more sad, if you will. Okay, so let's talk about the strings for this second part. We have the Albion strings, and as I've explained earlier, I'll begin with this quite small arrangement. You can see here we have the fifth. It's a root note, the D sharp, and the A sharp, and then we fill in the thirds. So this is an open voicing. And I also have this second string patch. It's from Omnisphere, the Adagio Espresso Expressive. And I really like to layer this string patch with the Albion strings or Cinematic strings too, or Hollywood strings. It's a very good layering string patch. And it's also a little bit more lush arranged, so we only have this little dropping melody, and then it becomes more full with the whole chords. And then for the cellos, the cellos, we have Albion strings, the low patch, which is cellos in octaves with the bass and cello. It has a very nice and clean low end, very fat low end. But we don't want to stop there, so we add a sub bass underneath. And I was thinking just to use a regular sine wave bass, a pure sine, but I choose a triangle instead and used two oscillators with a quite narrow detuning, just 0.1. And then I added this sync window with a little bit of LFO attached to it, so it wobbles a little bit in the width, in the pulse width. Then we have some distortions and a little bit of compression to compress the sound. And with the sub. You can also see that I ride the volume of the sub here, to make it fit with the strings. And then for the ending, I added some extra violins from the Cinematic Strings 2. With some tremolo strings to fill in the top end a little bit more. And we also have a piano playing the last theme. It's heavily compressed, but it's in the mix and it works. And we have some Albion percussion. And the final trailer boom. And also some Korean percussion. and a bell filling in this end, and this trill played on this yang geum. So that's also a Korean instrument to give that Korean flavor. And we have the epic duel from 8Dio playing that role in the end, which is a very big sound, excellent for these endings. Okay, so that's the major part of the score. And yeah, to top it off, we of course have to add some acoustic real instruments to this. And for this track, I use this, it's called the Tru Che in, I actually bought it in Cambodia, but there's actually a Korean instrument that looks quite similar. It's extremely hard to play because you have to adjust the pitch both by pressing down and by sliding. So you have all the axes to think about while you are playing, and at the same time bow the instrument. So it's extremely hard to play, but it sounds really nice, and I love the overtone quality of it. If you ever heard the Witcher 3 soundtrack, you know exactly the overtone string scrubbing that I'm talking about. Okay, and that sounded like this. And for this part with the demon in the background, I added more scrubbing, this second layer of scrubbing. And also for the end, I was doing the scrubbing and increasing the dynamic. So we have this crescendo for the end. Extra material. Yeah, so that's the score for the Koryo Hall of Adventures. And the final thing that I did was just adding a little bit of volume ride, because you can see I have all the instruments on a bus. And to make it fit with the voiceover, I decreased the volume to -3.8 decibels during the voiceover section. And as soon as the voiceover ends, at the end of the trailer, I boost it up to 0 dB, so we have full sound spectrum power at the end. Now, if you want to support the Koryo Hall of Adventures Kickstarter campaign, you can check the link in the description to Red Scale's publishing webpage. I hope you enjoyed this little behind the scenes video. Please shoot me any comments in the comments section if you have any questions on this scoring session. Now you can continue and watch my next video. My name is Mattias, and thanks for watching today. See you in the next video. Bye bye. Extra material.